Hello, everyone, and I am back with another edition of KAMDI Conversations, and I, of course, am so excited once again to have my guests today, and this is a special treat because I have been loving this voice for a very long time, and I know you all have too. So before I officially introduce my guests, for those that join us, be sure you click the link at the top to allow StreamYard to see your name and leave us a note. Let us know you're here. Tell our guests hello and where you're posting from, where you are. So let us know. So without further ado, please help me welcome my guest this evening. She is a very special person with a very special voice. She is the voice of the iconic song, Juicy Fruit, that I know everybody knows. And you may have heard her in some other things that we're going to talk about a little later. But please help me welcome the beautiful songstress, Miss Tawatha Agee. Welcome, Ms. Tawatha. Thank you so much for joining me today.
It's my pleasure being here. It's my pleasure.
I have to tell you, I happened to catch Pass the Mic.
Oh, yeah.
And, you know, I love those anyway, but I was surprised. I never know, of course, who's going to be on there, right. But I was pleasantly surprised to see you.
Yeah.
And really excited. And even
I was like, she's still singing?
Yes. You know, it's like, oh, there's Tawatha Agee, you know.
I got a lot of that. Yeah.
Yes. It was awesome, which made me say, you know what? You were on my list but you to want an interview, but I said, let me move that up and let me call and get in touch with her now. Let me find her.
I appreciate that very, very much.
Yes. And I have to tell you, you did a remarkable job. You sound phenomenal. And I know, how old is Juicy Fruit?
Ooh, 1983.
Yeah, it's been around for a little while.
It's been around.
But you know what? It never gets old. Never. So
no, because it keeps growing. It keeps growing. A new generation keeps learning that song. So it'll be around forever. I love it. I was going to say,
how does that make you feel? That song.
I think it's the most amazing thing to know that you've done something that people will remember. And no matter what incarnation it's in, because your mother knows Juicy, your auntie knows Juicy, your grandmother knows Juicy, and all the kids and uncles know Juicy Fruit. So in one configuration or another, either it's Biggie's version, our version, or whoever else has sampled it. It's wonderful.
And that's like, you just named this three generations right there that you're talking about.
Yes.
Maybe more. And I think it's just going to, and that's what you call good music, everybody.
So, yes. Yes.
And I have to say, I honestly don't know how many songs of today will have longevity like those kind of songs from back then.
Well, I know every artist hopes that their song lasts a long time, but you know, it's the people who decide what that is.
That's true.
Yeah.
But music has changed so much. And I'm just saying that, you know, that's 83 and we're still listening to it.
Yeah.
I just don't know if some of the songs these days are, you know, going to last that long. So that's giving credit to you and Mtume and what a phenomenal job you all did.
Thank you. And I thank you
because that's one of my favorites.
Mine too.
if you might say so yourself, right?
If I might say so myself, that's one of my favorites. Yeah.
Absolutely. And I can see why. Hey, John Cunningham is saying hello. He always tunes in.
Hi, John.
So thanks, John, for watching and tuning in. So we're going to go ahead and get started because we got a lot to cover, but a lot of people may not know. They may just know Juicy Fruit, but I want to explore everything about you because I know more about you, but I want everybody to know and give you your accolades because you deserve them so very much. So if you don't mind, let's start at the beginning. Can you tell us how this whole journey of music got started for you?
Okay. I grew up in Newark, New Jersey, and I was always listening to music, always listening to the radio, because that's what we had then, always listening to the radio. Knew all the songs on the radio, listened to every type and style of music. I was an avid reader, and I would read about people who were singers in, as they used to say, foreign land. So, you know, in Europe, in Africa, and, you know, places like that. And so it's like, and I used to read the liner notes on records, and I said, one day, I'm gonna see my name on these liner notes.
Yes.
And so I went to a music and arts high school, and then I went to Howard University where I graduated way back in the day. And I got a degree in music education.
Mm-hmm.
And I was singing in gospel groups in at Howard, and I sang in the Howard Gospel Choir, and I sang in a group with Richard Smallwood and the famous psalmist and Angela Winbush.
Yes.
And another gentleman by the name of Shelton Becton, who was an excellent pianist, and Elette Ricks. We were a group called Hot Tea. Mm-hmm. And we would sing, or Genesis. If we were singing in church, it was Genesis. If we were singing someplace else, it was Hot Tea. Well, you know, you can't limit yourself.
So we
were students at Howard, and a friend of ours by the name of Louise West said that, you know, she knew some gentlemen who were looking for people to produce. So, you know, we wanted to meet them, and we met, and it just happened to be James Mtume and Reggie Lucas, who were writing partners. And we did some of their songs. We demoed some of their songs. And that didn't really work out, but it just so happened that Mtume and I lived in the same town. So after I had graduated from Howard, he got in touch with me and asked that, he told me about sessions. I didn't know about sessions. I'm trying to be a teacher, you know, but I couldn't get a job as a full-time teacher. So I was a substitute teacher. So, you know, that's like, maybe you work and maybe you don't.
Right. And Tawatha, where were you at this? What city were you in at this time?
Washington, D.C. and at Howard, of course. And then I was in Newark, New Jersey.
Okay. Then Newark, New Jersey.
Trying to be a teacher, trying to do what my parents wanted, you know, go to school, get your degree and get a good job. But it didn't work out that way because I couldn't find a job as a teacher, full-time position. So Mtume called me after graduation and I came back home to Jersey, and he said he was going to start a band, and he asked if I would like to sing in the band. And I said, yeah, why not? Because, you know, I didn't have anything to lose.
Little did you know what was going to happen with that, did you?
As they say, tiny did I realize. But, you know, one session after the other just rolled into something that became phenomenal. Yes. And I appreciate him and the opportunities that he gave me and the energy that I brought to what he was trying to do. So, you know, it's a good partnership. Good part.
Absolutely. I would say so. Yes.
Yes.
And so tell us, what was it like actually working with Mtume? He's so talented. What was that experience like?
Well, you know, it was total learning experience because I had never worked with a band before. This was the first band that I worked with choirs. I sang in choirs.
Okay.
I played for choirs, but I never sang in a band before. And these were all professional musicians, and they had toured with Miles Davis and Roberta Flack.
Oh, wow. Yes.
That kept me on my toes because, you know, I didn't want to be the only one that was like slowing things down. So, you know, I had to bring my A-plus game.
Yes, you did.
Just to be with them. And it was a great union. I consider them my family.
That's wonderful.
Yeah.
Those were some big names. Miles Davis. Yes. Those are some good musicians.
Oh,
so
yeah.
do you remember your first time performing live with the band?
I remember my first time performing live. I don't remember the city, but I remember the drive to the stadium, you know, because we were in a car. We didn't even have a bus. We were in cars.
Okay.
We had a car van driving to whatever town, USA. And I was talking, and then I started to get excited. And then I was going so fast, I didn't even know what I was saying. So I was nervous because it was my very first time on stage with the Mtume band and in front of lots of people. Had it been a church, no problem.
You would have been fine.
This was like a stadium. So it's like, oh Lord, help me. So,
a stadium at that. Okay.
Yes. But I got through it and, you know, got rid of that stage fright and then was like, okay, I can do this. As long as my family's with me, you know, I had the band was my support.
Yes.
So, you know, it was good.
And you were the only female, right?
The only female.
Yes.
Ever. Okay. Yeah. Oh, no. Once we had another background singer. Her name was Renda Farrington. Once, way long time ago. When we did Soul Train, she was with us once.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
All right. So you see how special you were. You couldn't even be replaced to walk.
Oh.
No, that's funny. You know what? What do you think about today's music, Tawatha? We kind of touched on it a few minutes ago, but what do you think about it?
Well, you know, there's good. It's what I like, and it's what some people consider good, and what some people don't consider good. I mean, everybody likes what they like. You know, yes. What sells is not necessarily something that I like.
Right. Well, that's true.
But who I really love as artists today, and some names might be a little older than the others, but Bilal, Rahsaan Patterson, mm-hmm. Raheem Devon. I like Jasmine Sullivan. I like mm-hmm. Lettucey. Of course, Erykah Badu. But that's going back. But you know, but they're still prime. They're still in their prime. They're still singing. Yes. And some of the you know, Jasmine Sullivan is the newest one with the newest release. But she's been around for a while because she's a great songwriter.
Right.
She's a great songwriter and an even greater singer. I love her.
I do too. I love Jasmine Sullivan. And she left us for a little while. She stepped out for a minute and then she came back.
Yeah, you know, you have to think about if this is what you really want to do. You know, so, you know, she did that and came back. And I'm glad she came back. And she came back on her terms.
She sure did. Yes. That's commendable for her.
Yes.
These days especially. So, and you kind of answered, I was going to ask you, so who's on your playlist now? If you were to go to your playlist right now, who would be on your playlist?
Oh, right now? I would. Okay. On my playlist, it would be all gospel singers. It would be Fred Hampton. It would be Ty Tribbett. Anything commissioned, you know.
Oh, okay.
Commissioned. Anybody that's ever sang in that group, the Winans, the Clark sisters. Kirk Franklin, of course, you know, the contemporary king. And even back to James Cleveland and the Caravans, and of course, Aretha.
Wow. You just named quite a list there.
No, it's like, you know, I've been around for a minute, so I love a lot of things that I like.
Yes. And so it's all gospel on your list. No R&B at all?
But you know, the singers that I like are to me, the subject matter is different, but the singers are all great. Okay. The subject matter is different. I like Lettucey. I like Jasmine. Okay. I like SZA. You know, so it's a nice mix.
Yeah,
if you change the lyrics, it's like you wouldn't know who was singing what.
So, yes.
You know.
Okay. So tell us after Mtume.
Dietrich Haddon. How could I leave Dietrich Haddon? Love Dietrich Haddon. Dietrich Haddon.
Okay. I don't want you to neglect anybody. No problems.
Because you know, he sampled Juicy Fruit also.
Ah. Then yes. You definitely don't want to forget him.
Don't want to leave him out. No. When I heard it, it was like, oh my goodness, this is, and he added a twist to it that made it this even more amazing.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
Let's talk about before I was going to move from Mtume, but before we move from Mtume, let's go ahead and talk about Juicy Fruit.
Okay.
So the making and how it came to be, and did you feel like it was going to be a hit, or were you?
Well, you know, when Mtume tracked Juicy, I was on tour with somebody else because I've always worked with other people. Mm-hmm. I was in Europe touring with a group called Roxy Music, and he called me and said, we have one more song to do. So I had to fly mm-hmm. back home and do this last song. And the last song was Juicy Fruit. And then I had to go right back. And so when the album, the song was released, he would keep me abreast of how it was doing. And you know, it would, you know, out of the top 100, it was like 90. It's like, oh wow, okay, you know, this is not gonna happen. And then it was 70 and 50 and then 10, 9, 8, 7. Then it was one for like number one for 8 weeks. So it's like, oh my God, it seems like we got a hit on our hands. And so when I was touring with Roxy Music, we performed in New York City and they were kind enough to play Juicy Fruit during their intermission. So, you know, it was really good. And then I had to get ready for the Mtume tour, but you know, so we could do Juicy Fruit.
Okay. Very good. So
what a life. I mean, I'm like,
yes.
Always going in circles and just, you know, landing and doing what I have to do and then go on to the next thing.
So you were doing different groups simultaneously or?
Yeah. Cause I wasn't when he was tracking Juicy Fruit, mm-hmm. I was on tour with another band, but a pop band. So it was, I was touring Europe Europe. So, you know,
okay.
I was gone for like 6 weeks, but he had one last song to do, and that last song was Juicy Fruit.
And that was your biggest hit, too.
And that's the biggest hit.
Saved the best for last. And then one more Mtume song I want to talk about, of course, and that's the other one, You, Me, and He.
Oh, yeah. Wasn't that something?
That song, those lyrics were something else.
Everybody loves that. Yes. Everybody loves You, Me, and He. And when we did it live, Tanya, it was so amazing when we did that live because everybody loved that song. Oh, whether they loved it positively or negatively, they loved that song.
I don't know if that was from personal experience, but I know a lot of people probably could relate to it.
That's why I think so. It was something everyone could relate to. Yes. And he wrote that, and Tume wrote that.
Okay. I guess that's a question for him, maybe. Okay. But we love both of those in the video.
Oh, yes. Oh, the video was great. Yeah.
Yes, it was told that story. Mm-hmm. We do have a question. It says, hello, everybody. How did Tawatha come to write on Stephanie Mills' debut album? And were any of the songs used on Stephanie's album originally intended for Tawatha's solo project?
Well, you know, with Mtume Lucas Productions, when they had a project coming up, they would allow us to submit material for the project. Mm-hmm. And that's how I got songs on each of their projects. And they might be talking about Two Hearts, which she did with Teddy Pendergrass that I wrote, and Tume and Reggie helped me with that. But they would allow us to submit material for a possible project. So everybody was, you know, it was very competitive, and it was very generous of them to open it up to us like that. So how I got songs on that Stephanie Mills project. And no, it was not meant for me. It wasn't meant for me. It was a song that I submitted during the Stephanie Mills project.
Okay. So that answers that question. Mm-hmm. Somebody saying Mtume really had it going on. Yes, he did.
Yes, he did.
Yes, he did. Yes. So let's move from Mtume that, because after that you had a solo album, correct? So
I did a solo. It was a project, a part of the Mtume Lucas Productions. It was a project. And so if it had done well, it's like, well, then I'll work on the solo project, but if not, I'm out on tour with the next group. And that's what happened. Yeah. Okay. I think that album, it didn't do well. It didn't do well at all, but people know it and people like it, mm-hmm. but it wasn't enough for me to stop and, you know, and tour.
Well, you definitely had a lot going on, though. It's not like you did that, but it didn't stop you from anything.
No, I
would have loved to have heard more of you doing a solo
thing, yeah,
right.
Well, that's coming. That's always there. That's always there.
Well, okay.
Other people need my services. Other people need my services, and so you know that keeps me traveling, which is something I love to do.
Wonderful. So yeah. I was going to ask what you like to do in your spare time, downtime. So traveling now that you're able to again, right?
Yes. Now that things are opening up, and now I can think about music more. Now, I mean, music. You know, my own personal stuff. Project now. So, you know, it's a good time.
So I'm going to go ahead and bring in DJ Doc.
All right, DJ Doc.
Yes, we're going to bring him in and have a little fun. So let's add him. Hey, DJ Doc.
Hey, I've been impatiently waiting.
Well, for those, if it's your first time with us, you know, we have the KAMDI mini mix with DJ Doc, and he's going to play some songs. Let's see if you know any of them. You can post them in the comments section and see if you know any, and we'll share what they are at the very end. So, DJ Doc, I'm going to hand it over to you right now.
All right. This right here is the KAMDI mini mix right here. We're going to see if you can guess these songs right here. And we have Tawatha Agee, right? Did I say that right?
Agee.
Mm-hmm. From Mtume.
Yeah.
Yeah, y'all know the hits. So I'm about to drop a few of those hits to see if y'all can name each song. Whoever can name them, you might get some. You know what I'm saying? So if y'all ready, let me know. Y'all
all
ready?
Right, here we go.
Okay, here we go.
DJ Doc. Go. Social media at Andre Doc Williams.
We know that one.
Yeah, some more coming up though.
Ready for the next one?
Came into my life, a stranger. You got into my heart.
I'm dancing with
the
right now.
Now I got to face the danger. I'm ready to start.
Don't think I can make it on my own. All alone. I try so hard to make it. Now the truth must be known.
Day by day.
Ah, yes.
Bring you here with me.
That voice.
Or just
what about this one right here? What about this one right here?
Tell me what can it be?
What about this one right here?
Oh, that's nice. That was nice.
Try and understand.
Tawatha Agee right here from Mtume.
There's another.
DJ Doc, Candy Mix. Matanya Hawley.
In my life, he's my lover.
I wonder what you're
talking about. Sing it, Tawatha.
What are you talking about here?
DJ Doc.
Yeah. DJ Doc.
Thank you, DJ Doc. That was
beautiful. Great. That was beautiful. I loved it.
They are naming them over here. Let's see what we got.
Let's see what we got.
Are you serious?
Okay, that's one.
Somebody said one of a kind, juicy fruit. Mm-hmm. Sugar free.
Which was not in Tume.
Uh-oh.
Oh. Two hearts. Let's and I'll let you name them all when I'm done because I don't know if they got them all.
Yeah.
Did I dream you? Somebody got they got them. You got
they got them.
And then you, me, and he. So go ahead and name them. I think they got them all.
Yeah.
Okay. You ready? You ready for me to expose it?
Yes.
So yes. Number one was serious. Are you serious? Number two was juicy fruit. Number three, sugar free, which was not in Tume. Mm-hmm. Then we had two hearts. That was Stephanie Mills and Teddy P.
Which Tawatha wrote.
Yes. Did I dream you? And you, me, and he.
Very good. Good job. Thank you.
No problem. I love your music. Keep it going.
Thank you.
And where can we find you, DJ Doc?
You can find me at Flex92.3. Go to Flex923.com. Also at WXIR 100.9 WXIR.com. And you can hear me spin. And you can also catch Tanya on 92.3 as well on Saturday.
Right.
Actually will broadcast on that station.
Cool.
So those that missed it, you can hear it and also on the YouTube channel, but he's going to rebroadcast this. So thank you so much, DJ Doc. Always a pleasure. Great job.
Thanks, DJ Doc.
No problem. Anytime.
See you next time.
All right. See y'all later.
Okay. Later. Peace.
All right. Very good. And so who was sugar free? Bye.
You know what? They opened for us a few times and much later that was Catrice and Jerry Barnes. I can't remember the group name, but they were brother and sister duo. Okay. And she later became the music director of Saturday Night Live.
Wow.
So, yes. She was an excellent pianist. Actually, she passed away a few years ago. Oh, okay. So, but no, Catrice Barnes and Jerry Barnes. They did.
Thank you. Great music, great mix. We enjoyed hearing. I love to hear your music. I like to see your reaction, the artist's reaction. Yeah. When you haven't heard something in a little while, it's like,
oh. Right. It's like, oh my God, was I ever that young?
Yeah. And I got artists singing along and I'm like, ooh, we having a little concert going on.
Mm-hmm.
But again, when I saw you not too long ago and passed the mic, you sounded phenomenal. So we're going to get to what you're up to now, but before we do that, I want to transition. So what happened after Mtume and your solo project? Where do we go from there? What happened?
Let's see. After Well, you know, it wasn't like it was after. It was like everything was sort of intertwined. Okay. I worked with Luther Vandross. I sang on just about all of his albums, like 90% of his albums.
Yes, I know. I remember your name. I used to read the liner notes on all my albums. That's why I knew your name.
Yes, yes. And I worked with Luther and the people that he produced, like Aretha Franklin. And, and Aretha liked the vocals that we did so much. She wanted the people that sang on the record to sing with her live. And so I had a chance. I worked with Aretha for like 10 years.
Oh, wonderful.
And then there was David Bowie. And then it was the Dave Matthews Band. Then there was Chromeo. It's so many groups. I mean, yes. It's a lot. And recently I was honored at the Women Songwriters Hall of Fame in Washington, D.C.
Congratulations.
And, thank you. And they honored me for my body of work. And it's like, there were so many names of people that I had worked with. It was like, I had to make the list short because I only had a limited time for my acceptance speech.
Oh, so, wow.
But I tried to put everybody in, but of it's, course. You know, I mean, oh my God. Luther, Aretha, of course, Stephanie and Teddy, Dave Matthews Band, Luther, Aretha, Chromeo, David Bowie. Oh my God. And the list goes on and on.
Yeah, I have some written down if you forgot some. I got David Sanborn, LaVert, Kashif.
There's so many.
Al Jarreau, Steely Dan. I got
Steely Dan. I toured with Steely Dan. I toured with Lenny Kravitz. And also sang on their albums. So, you know, it's been a nice run for me. That's all I could say. And if you want to see the full list, you can go to my website, www.tawathaag.com, and you can see the full list or the current. It's always being updated.
Very impressive list.
Thank you.
And let's talk about jingles, because you're also known or were sought after in doing jingles as well.
As a jingle singer. And, jingles are the commercials that you hear on television and radio. You know, when you're selling a product or somebody's holding up a glass or a bottle or some kind of product, candy, cereal, whatever. Mm-hmm. And then you're singing behind that. And what I wanted to, what I like to talk about when I do interviews is that, you know, when you're a performer, you don't always have to be in the front. You don't have to be the soloist,
right?
You know, because there are lots of other jobs
that's true
that are behind the scenes. Like when you do jingles, you're not on camera, but people hear your voice.
That's right.
You know, and so, and that can be a really, really a lucrative a business. And also, when I used to do TV shows, or I used to do Saturday Night Live, sometimes we'd be on camera, but most of the time, I was singing in the booth, so you never even saw me. So when they would do their skits and they'd have musical numbers, we'd mm-hmm. There would be singers in the booth singing to accompany the people in the show. So it's good, and then just singing background. Period is right. Just a wonderful, wonderful thing because you get a chance to work with different artists and you know. But if your goal is to be the main artist, I mean, that's fine. But you know, right. But there's serious work in just doing the background and everybody that sings background can't sing solo.
Right.
And everybody that sings solo can't sing background.
And you are blessed. You're able to do both. I'm glad you made that point, especially for people who might be listening or watching that don't realize that, you know, there's other opportunities than being just in the front.
Exactly. Wait a minute. Now, when you're in the front, you know, you get paid, but then you got to pay everybody else.
That's true.
So by the time you pay everybody else, you coming out with the least amount of money.
Right.
That's funny. So it's good to be in the back. I just want people to know that there are opportunities, you know, without being the headliner.
Thank you for saying that.
Yes.
And to go along with that, well, first let me ask you this. Are there some jingles that we might be familiar with that you have done do you remember any that you could share with us?
Well, you know, with jingles, it was just you're singing the name of the product. And so right. I've done like Kentucky Fried Chicken. I've right. done a Dove soap. I've done the, when airlines used to have jingles back yes. in the day. I've done Burger King. I've done soft drinks and just lotion, shampoo. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's you know, a lot of different things. Like I said, but if you go to the website, you'll see the complete.
They're all there. I know. I saw that list. Yeah. I just wanted you to name a few because it was very long. I wasn't.
Yes, it was long. It was so long until it's like, you know, I'm not going to remember everything because it's just like it's been a lot of years and a lot of, you know, different things and different combinations of things. So all I can say is you don't always have to be in the front because all those with all those jingles, nobody ever saw the singers.
That's nobody true. Ever saw the singers. You don't have to be in the spotlight to have a career in this business. And so for artists or potential artists or people who are thinking about being artists, what advice would you give them? That was great what you just said. And that's one thing that they can definitely take. But is there anything, what would you tell them about this journey or advice you would give to them?
Oh, just be up on your craft. And don't stop learning. Don't think that what you're doing is the only way. I mean, that's one avenue, but you have to be open to hearing everything, open for advice, open to rejection, because, you know, when you're going out trying to sell yourself or your product, your songs, it's like sometimes people are not going to like what you do, but then other people will love it. So you can't let a no, you know, be the be all and end all. You know, you're not going to be crushed because you get a no. You know, your career is not over because you get a no. Your career is not over if you have a record that doesn't sell, you know, because you can always do another one. You can always do another one. But, you know, it's just you have to know your craft and be open to suggestions. But be an individual. Don't try to be the next whoever the main person is right now. Be yourself.
There you go. I love it. Thank you for that. That's great advice. A couple of comments I want to read to you. A couple people are saying a few things. Oh, the group was Juicy, you were trying to think of.
Oh, okay. Which is probably all I can remember because Juicy, they opened for us and sang Juicy. And then we came out and did, you know.
Okay.
So, you know, it's the little, you know, it's a thing. It's a thing. But they were cool.
Someone saying your voice was sensational on all Luther Vandross albums, but you were everywhere. That's what they're saying.
Yes.
Very talented. Someone saying I keep coming across Tawatha singing with Angela Wimbush in the group Hot Tea.
Yes. Yes. The college days.
That's awesome. Do you and Angela still keep in touch? Or
we're very good friends. Friends.
That's awesome. She's another phenomenal singer.
Oh, my God. She's amazing.
Y'all have some talent in that group. I'm telling you. I mean,
and, you know, and everybody's just doing their thing. And it's like, but it meshed together so well.
Oh, I'm sure.
And with the group Hot Tea, everyone went on to do something different, but everyone went on to become successful.
Yes.
So, and I think that's the whole purpose of the university experience, you know, just to learn something there and then go out and do your own thing.
You're right there at an HBCU. So.
Yes.
So
yes.
Do you regret, I know the answer, I think, not being able to teach or go more into teaching?
No, I don't regret that at all. Because what I do is when I find young people who are interested in learning the craft, I mean, I can give them suggestions or just the recommendations about how to go about things or how things are or how things used to be and what they could do to come into the fold. So I wouldn't say I was so much a teacher. I'm a nurturer.
Oh, I love it.
I'm a nurturer.
And nurturers sometimes teach different kinds.
Well, but I don't have a classroom. It's right. Whoever's there at the time. It's
right.
Like if there's a new singer in the group, I put her under my wing. And him or her under my wing, and then just help him out, give him pointers about what the protocol should be, because there's an art to singing background. It's you just don't go up in there and you're on stage and shaking your butt and that's it. That's what it looks like on television. But
right.
That's not what it is. That's not what it is.
Well, television has a lot of stuff people don't get. You know.
Well, and sometimes those people aren't even singing. So
yeah.
you know. That's why you need real singers in the background.
Right. There you go. Here's a question for you. Based based on your professional experience, what advice would you give your younger self?
Not to be so shy, because I was very, very shy. Because I didn't know, you know, I'm this girl who just graduated from college from an HBCU, which is also known as a party school. I never went to a party. Went to one party. So I was always in class or in church. So it was like, I would tell my younger self to be more open and be try to be more sociable, you know.
Okay.
But I was soaking everything in though. And then all of a sudden I just like it burst, you know, but I blossomed. I blossomed and here I am today.
Yes, blossom to a beautiful flower.
Yes.
Someone is asking, what did you study in college? Wasn't it music education?
I majored in music education, yes.
Yes, so I know you had mentioned that earlier. I think they had missed that. Okay.
Yeah.
And I would like to know, have you worked with Patrice Rushen?
I haven't, but our paths have crossed. Okay. As a matter of fact, Mtume knows Patrice very well. So I think they used to work together, you know, with the jazz thing. So I don't do that much jazz. Our paths have definitely crossed. And side note, her husband was the road manager for Lenny Kravitz when I worked with him.
Okay, so, there's another name we didn't mention, Lenny Kravitz. There you go.
Oh yeah, Lenny. Oh, the rock, chief rocker, Lenny. Yes.
And what I love about you, and you can tell just by all the names that we have mentioned, all the artists and the groups that you've worked with, it's such a variety. It's not just R&B, it's not just jazz, you know, it's R&B with jazz, with gospel, you name.
And there's some country in there and rock, and you know, so it's been a great experience just to be able to sing different genres of music, whether I'm singing at the Kennedy Center for the Kennedy Center Honors in the band, or whether I'm singing at the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame or any other award show. I mean, it's all, and because when you do those award shows, you're singing behind everyone. And so it's different style, artists have different styles. And so you have to accommodate the artist by singing in the style that they're working in. So it's been a great, great experience. I wouldn't change it for the world.
Wonderful. And what's your favorite genre of music?
Oh, gospel music.
I had a feeling you were going to say that.
Yes. That's what sustains me. That's what I'm playing all the time. No matter who I'm working for, it's on the playlist.
That's wonderful. Yeah. Because, you know, lyrics are important. And the lyrics that you receive in gospel music are always uplifting. And you're filling yourself with those kind of lyrics and words. So that always makes a difference. That's wonderful.
In a mood, I listen to John P. Key or Fred Hampton or Dietrich Haddon or Kirk Franklin or, you know, any of them, all of them. You know?
Yes.
Yeah.
Mr. Vaux Kalman, PDG, that's what his name says. I don't know who that is, but I'm trying to pronounce it. But he says, please tell Tawatha how beautiful she looks tonight.
Oh, thank you. Thank you very much. You know, we try.
Yes. You look great. So, Tawatha, I think I know the answer to this, but I'm going to let you answer. Do you play any instruments?
Yes, I do.
What instruments?
I play piano. I play enough to accompany myself. Okay. And when I was working with Mtume, everyone was, they were like, master musician, so I would be too shy to play in front of them, you know. So I'd have my little piano and play and take my songs, but I never played on stage because the band was amazing, so there was no need, you know. All I had to do was sing, but I do play piano.
Okay. Do you play the guitar as well? I thought I read that somewhere. Did you ever?
Well, you know, I can do a few licks. I can do a chink-to-chink, you know. But at the time when we were performing, I didn't want to cut my nails, you know, because I wanted my fingernails. Oh, so it's like, you can't play the guitar with long fingernails. So, but I could do a chink-chink, chink, because, you know, it was a funk band. So it's not like I needed to be.
Yes, that's true. That's very true. I love it. Okay. But you say you can accompany yourself playing the piano, but not for a performance. Is that what
you're saying? No, I just do that for my personal.
Okay.
Or if I'm writing something, I can do that. Or I'll show the piano player how to play it, but I won't play.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's good to be able to do that.
Yes.
So what was your favorite, who was your favorite artist to tour with?
Mm-hmm.
And the second part to that is what was your favorite or most memorable performance?
Okay. Favorite artist to tour with other than Mtume. Mtume is a given.
Outside of Mtume, because that's the only
thing. Hands down, that would be the Dave Matthews Band.
Because
it was most similar to Mtume because they were very improvisational. And they had a different mixture of instruments as opposed to just piano, bass, and drums. They had other instruments, other instruments that you wouldn't expect. And they were the most innovative, and it allowed me to grow musically, vocally, and because you know Dave was. Dave is from South Africa, so there was a different texture to some of the things that he had written. And so with the combination of the horns and the guitar and the violin, all of this in one band, it was amazing. And so that was my most memorable. And what was the second half to the question?
Well, who was your favorite person to perform with or tour with? And the other was, what's your most memorable performance?
Okay. In 2019, I had a chance to sing with Brian Ferry and Roxy Music. And this was the same group that I worked with like in the 80s.
Okay.
And they were being inducted in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame.
Oh, nice.
And we sang a song where I had a step out and I got a standing ovation at the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. So I don't even know if it was filmed. All I know is I was there, and it was like it was the most amazing thing because it was a song that I had sung like 20 years ago. You know,
and what was the group, the band?
The band was Brian Ferry and Roxy Music. They were inducted in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame in 2019.
Okay,
and then as a result of that, he asked me and the other singer, which was Fonzie Thornton, to do his U.S. tour. And after we did the U.S. tour, he asked us to do his European tour. And so I was gone all of 2019. And then when I got back, the pandemic happened and everything was like shut down. So,
wow. You know. And let's talk about that for a minute. So what have you been doing? It's kind of getting better now, but that time you were off and, you know, we were in lockdown. Mm-hmm. Are you still in Newark? Where are you now?
I'm still in Jersey, but I'm not in Newark.
Oh, you're in Jersey though. What were you doing? How did you spend your time?
Well, you know, being in the house can be, you know, even if you have a lot of room, it can still be very lonely.
Yes.
You know, so you just go to a different room every day or something, but it's like, it was a daunting time because it was not, you know, I wasn't really happy because I couldn't go anywhere. And then people were sick and then you would see the news and it was like, oh, nothing was, it was like, it was very dark time. But, you know, I had my music that I could listen to. I had my, you know, my gospel music that I could listen to when things really, really got closed in, you know, I couldn't go anywhere. I couldn't see my family. My family wasn't here. My family's in another state.
So
I was basically alone. So it was like, oh boy, as soon as this thing is over, I'm getting out of here. But I did have an opportunity to work where the people sent the recording equipment to my house so I could record, you know, at the house. And, but I can't say who it is, but the movie's coming out in August, and it's a woman who is an Oscar winner.
Okay.
That's all I can say. And she is a Black woman who is an Oscar winner.
Wonderful.
A movie coming out next month in August.
Okay, that you did the soundtrack. I'm assuming this is the soundtrack.
The soundtrack, yeah.
Okay, wonderful.
Yes, yes.
Congratulations, yes. I can't wait. I'm gonna have my ear out looking for it. I'm gonna have to get in touch with you and find out.
Yes. I hope it's a big movie. I hope it.
Because I hope
they've been really advertising a lot for it. So I'm hoping that.
Oh, I'm sure it will be. Yeah. I'm sure it will be. So Tawatha, before we close, I want to play this little game sometimes I play with artists.
Okay.
And I'm going to say the name of an artist, and mm-hmm. I want you to tell us the first word or first thing that comes to mind.
Okay.
Okay. And you'll know all of them. Of course, you know all the artists anyway. So.
Okay.
So let's start. You tell us the first thing that comes to mind. Aretha Franklin.
Queen.
That was an easy one, Lynn. Okay.
Well, you know, I used to have her poster in my dormitory room. And
wow.
I told myself one day I was going to work with her.
Look at that.
And then it's like, look at God, you know.
Look at that. Yes.
I had her poster in my dorm room. And, you know, one of those really, you know, big ones. And
oh, I know exactly the size you're talking about.
Queen of Soul. One day.
That's wonderful. Yeah. I love it. Look, I had the Jackson 5 in mind. Maybe something will happen for me later on. Some of the Jacksons somewhere. Anyway,
all things are possible. All things
that's
are
right.
possible.
Yeah. Celine Dion.
Oh, what a voice. I did something with her and R. Kelly. They did a Christmas record together. And I sang background on that. But what an amazing instrument. An amazing instrument. That's all I'll say about her. Amazing okay. instrument. Amazing
Wonderful.
Instrument.
Yes. Well, since you said R. Kelly, let's say R. Kelly.
Okay.
What's first thing that comes to mind for him?
I love his early works.
Okay.
Yeah.
Fair enough.
Mm-hmm.
Stephanie Mills.
Oh my God, a human dynamo with the biggest voice in the world. When mm-hmm. we had an opportunity to do a reference vocal together, because initially Two Hearts was supposed to be just a solo, one person singing.
Oh, okay.
And then Mtume decided it's going to be a duet. So we were both in a studio and he said, you all go in and just sing. And so we sang Two Hearts as a duet. And it was the most amazing time at the microphone that I have ever had with anybody.
Oh, wow. I wish.
Because we're both really short people, you know, and but we sing to the rafters.
Oh, yeah. So, your voices. The heads got nothing on your voices.
It was so
yes.
big. It was amazing. And of course, no one has the tape.
Nobody recorded. I was just going to ask that question. Anybody recorded? That would have been something to really hear. I would have loved that. Oh, well.
I would love to hear that. But you know what? That was so special until that would just be like between the two of us, you know?
Yes. Understood.
Yeah. Yeah. So that was a moment. Yeah.
Let's see here. I'm going to go with a group this time. Next name.
Okay.
Let's say Earth, Wind and Fire.
Oh my goodness. My college days at Howard, it was just Earth, Wind and Fire all the time. Reasons. Oh my God. You know, and just, you know, with their costuming and the kalimba and That's the Way of the World. And it's like, Earth, Wind and Fire. I love them.
One more. Cool in the Gang.
Cool in the Gang. My favorite from Cool in the Gang is Summer Madness.
Ooh.
And it's like, yeah, that's a sexy song. So it's like, yeah, I like that. You know, and they're from here. They're from Jersey.
Yes, they are.
You know, but love their music. Always have. And then, of course, what is it? Was it Ladies Night?
Probably.
Yeah, Ladies Night. Yes. Yeah. But Summer Madness, my favorite.
That's actually one of my favorites by the way.
That was touching. That touched to heart. You know?
Yeah, that's a very unique song. I love it.
Absolutely.
So let's do one more. Let's see where we're gonna go. How about the late great Al Jarreau?
Al Jarreau, you know, I sang on one of his albums that Nile Rodgers produced, and I think the song we sang on was L is for Lover. He was such a nice man. He was very friendly and he would come out and talk to us, you know, while we're in the studio, he'd come out and talk and he was very friendly and just, it's like, wow, I wish everybody, more artists were like that.
And I know I said it was my last one, but I...
Well, you know what? You can call them all out because I'm ready.
You have stories sometimes, and I love to hear the stories. I think people like to hear that too.
Right, because the name will always be associated with a story.
Right.
You know, unless and it's like the queen, you know, it's like, what can I say?
Well, here's one I know you have a story for, and it's my favorite of all, and that is Luther Vandross.
Oh, I went to Luther Vandross University. I am a graduate of Luther Vandross University. I sang on his, when I first met Luther, I hired him to sing on a project for Mtume Lucas. So, and we met, we became friends, and he said, you know, if some jobs come up, I'll call you. Mm-hmm. And they did. And I sang on his demo, Never Too Much.
Oh my goodness.
I sang on his demo and he kept Never Too Much, You Stop Loving Me, and Don't You Know That. That's three songs off the first album. And he kept the reference vocals that we did. So that Philip Ballou and myself did. And so that was great. Luther was the funniest man ever, but he knew what he wanted from every singer. He had such a great sense of humor and such a great sense of style. And he knew what he wanted. He visualized what he wanted to see on that stage. Mm. And he got people that could give him that. So I appreciate all of my time with Luther. Mm. And like I said, I sang on just from the demo, from Never Too Much to Dance With My Fathers. I sang on just about everything in between, except for the album he did in 1983, which is when Juicy Fruit came out. And I had to work my own
record. Yes, well, you get excused for that one.
That's the only time I didn't sing with Luther.
That's wonderful.
And maybe one other time. So like 98% of the time I was on all his projects.
And you, two of my favorite, I was listening to Never Too Much today. And Don't You Know That is another one of my favorites.
Oh, yes. Yeah. Oh, and that was Philip Ballou, the late Philip Ballou. Of course, the late Luther Vandross and myself singing.
I'm telling you that I love that song. So actually, we are down to the wire here, Tawatha. I'm going to read the last comments. Questions. I know you have to come back and see me. I love talking to you.
Okay. We have to make that work.
Absolutely. But a couple more just comments. I want to make sure I get them in. Sometimes I get in trouble. They get mad at me.
Okay.
CC Funk One says, hey, Tawatha, much respect, love, welcome to my dream and all the Mtume music.
Oh, thank you. I appreciate that. Much love, much love, much love.
And someone just posted Avalon.
Oh, Avalon. Yeah, that's what Brian Ferry and Roxy Music.
Oh, yeah. Okay. No. I was thinking about my Roxy Music album. Have you ever worked with Chaka or Whitney? That's the question.
You know what? I did. I worked with Chaka Khan when she was on the David Letterman show. So I didn't do any recordings or one of her performances. It was her performance on the David Letterman show, which was a late night talk show.
Right.
Chaka and who else?
Whitney.
Whitney. Did not work with Whitney, but her mother, Sissy Houston, gave me my first voice lesson.
Wow.
So, you know, everything we all run into each other, you know.
Yes.
I didn't work with Whitney because when I was singing, she was modeling then, you know, she wasn't even singing yet, but her mother gave me my first voice lesson. So that's my association with the Houston family.
Very good. And yes. David Bowie.
Such a gentleman. Ah, and he was very stately, such a gentleman. He knew his music like the back of his hand and so stylish and just, he was regal, but he was also funny. He wasn't, he was very personable. That's the word. He was very personable. And we did the Black Tie White Noise with Al B. Sure. And we did a promotional tour and it was great. It was great. We got a chance to meet Iman and his wife. And it's like, oh my God, it's Iman. And she's bringing us like brownies or something. And she's like, oh no, I don't eat that. But she was giving it to us to eat. So, you know, but he was such a great man.
Thank you for those wonderful stories and all you have shared with us. The last comment from our friend, Mr. Vocalman PDG, I think I'm saying that right. He says, oh, Tanya, this is my first time tuning into your show. Kudos to you. Thank you. This interview with Tawatha was very informative and entertaining. Thank you. So thank you for the compliment. And Tawatha, thank you for making it so easy for me to talk to you. It was wonderful.
One last thing, Tanya. Today, my interview came out with RollingStone.com. So it was like, so it's been a great day, even though like the power went out and everything.
But yes,
it's been a great day. So you can see that at RollingStone.com.
Wonderful.
Just blessed. That's all I can say. Blessed.
And thank you so much. So how can we keep in touch with you, follow you? Is there music coming out?
Yes, there will be music coming out, and on all that information will be on my website. It's www.tawathaag.com. It's a beautiful website. You can keep up with me and all the interviews and the tours and shows and all of that. And, you know, and it'll announce when new music will be coming out.
So for all our Unsungeteers, that's on, you know, we're live on the Fans of Unsung page, and we are affectionately called Unsungeteers. Make sure we support Tawatha. And I thank you all for joining us. I want to give a special thank you to Kevin Goins, who helped put all this together, who always helps me so much. We love you, Kevin. And of course, to Angelo Ellerby from Double Exposure Media.
Yes. Mr. Ellerby,
Shouts out to both of them for helping me do this tonight and putting Tawatha with me. Tawatha, you are wonderful. I wish you all the best.
I wish we had more time.
Hey, you can come back anytime.
I have to come back.
Absolutely. We'll play some more music because you got more stuff out there.
Yes.
And we'll talk about more artists. And, you know, when if you have some new music, you know, let me know. And
we can
certainly come back so we can help support you in that. Okay.
Thank you.
You're very welcome, Tawatha. Thank you so much. Everybody, thank you for tuning in. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel if you haven't, Tanya Hawley, the KAMDI group, and my Facebook page. Fans of Unsung, we'll see you soon. You all have a great day, and we'll see you soon. Bye-bye, everybody.